The Jackery HomePower 3000 is Jackery's latest 3000 watt hour unit. It's also the first unit to bear the name HomePower. So what's that all about, or is it just marketing? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. The HomePower 3000 is not to be confused with the Explorer 3000. It has no wheels or a suitcase handle. It has a bigger inverter and a slightly bigger battery. That battery is also LiFePO4 instead of lithium ion, which basically just means that it'll have a much bigger lifespan. Pretty much seems like they just updated the old 3000 to get it up to the standards of 2025. So it might not be as portable and convenient, but is that sacrifice worth the gain in performance? That's what we're here to find out. If at any point you've heard enough, check out the links down below. We'll leave any discount codes that we can get at a Jackery, as well as information on this month's giveaway. Give us a subscribe if you haven't already. But before we get into what we like and don't like about this guy, let's get you up to speed on the new Jackery HomePower 3000. First up, this passes the tiny baby lift test at only about 60 pounds. It's got a 3072 watt hour battery, which is not expandable, unfortunately. It says it has a 2400 watt inverter on the AC plugs and a 3600 watt inverter on the 30 amp plug, but we'll get into that later. It's got an 1800 watt AC input, so you can charge it up with a regular wall outlet in your house. And it also has 1000 watts maximum of solar input, which isn't that good for a unit this size. When it comes to the design of this guy, for ports, we have your 420 volt house outlets. We've got a 30 amp plug, a 12 volt car socket, two USB-A's and two USB-C's. On the left side, we have our AC input as well as our DC input and two AC breaker reset buttons. The screen on this guy is nice and simple. It tells you everything you need to know. It has your input and your output wattage rating as well as your battery percentage right in the middle. It's got your Bluetooth and Wi-Fi indicators in the corner of the screen, and that takes us into the app as well. The app is pretty good. It lets you control the unit from afar, turn on and off your inverter as you need to across the room. Basically, it just lets you tweak a few settings that you can't do right on the face of the unit. And right now, with our code, this unit is $2,124. To start off with what we like with this guy, we do like that the 30 amp outlet is a true 30 amp because of the inverter size. The old 3000 wasn't, so we just like that they updated that so you can pull a true 30 amps out of the 30 amp plug. It performed really well when it came down to our testing in the lab. It was very quiet when both running loads and charging. The efficiency testing for this guy was really good, and the idle consumption was only 8 watts.
Yeah, which is like, I think the best we've seen ever at the lab.
Yeah, crazy low for a power station of any size, let alone something with an inverter as big as this one. That means if you leave the AC inverter running on this guy with a very minimal load or something that cycles off and on like a sump pump, you'll get 16 days potentially out of this running time. That's huge. When it comes to design, we actually like that Jackery kept it pretty simple. They stayed in line with their typical Jackery look. They maintain the 12 volt car socket, which is super practical for anything like a fridge if you're on the go, any other car appliance. And while it did lose its wheels and suitcase handle, it's still light enough that the carry handles make it really easy to get around, and it is still really portable. We also like that Jackery is now selling bifacial panels. So if you're using this thing on the go, the solar efficiency is really good. So if you're buying into their products to go with their power stations, it's actually a really nice setup. But it's too bad this guy still only has 1000 watts of solar input. So you win some, you lose some. We also really like the calculator on Jackery's website. Most companies will overcompensate what they think their units can do. Their calculator takes into account its idle consumption, so it gives you a really realistic expectation of what the unit will put out with a given load when you're entering that on their website. When it comes to price, we feel that you're doing pretty well with this unit. They've improved a lot of things like the battery type, the battery size, and the inverter size. So to consider that you're getting a much better unit in the long run, and you lose, yeah, a little bit of efficiency in terms of having wheels or a handle, but to hold true to their original price on the old 3000, we think you're doing really well. When it comes to things we don't like, I know we touched on it already, the outlets on the front, they're labeled properly on the unit, just not on the back of the unit, not on the box, not on the website. So why not advertise the product as being capable of what it actually is? And that's not even like we're just pushing it to the 3600 and that's its surge rating. That was comfortable running there nonstop from full to finish. And then we were still able to surge it beyond the 3600, which would have been around its 7200 watt surge rating. Which that holds true as well with their 30 amp plug, which was also rated at 3600 watts. So it's just weird that they wouldn't advertise its full potential, but overall it performed really well and we were happy with it. Next up, we've got no light on this guy. We all know Robbie loves his lights on power stations. Come on, Jackery, you do it for all your small power stations. We want to see a light. It is still a portable unit. You can still pick this guy up, walk him down the stairs in a power outage. We want to see a light.
We don't want to be wearing headlamps for power outage. We want damn
light. It's 2025. Give us a light. Come on. The solar input on this guy is also pretty low at 1,000 watts of input. If you compare it to other power stations on the market of around the same size, usually you get a higher input of solar, even if it's split between two input ports. So you're gonna be waiting around a while for this guy to charge up in the sun if you take him out camping and you are relying on it for multiple days in a row. Maybe consider that when you're looking at the purchase. We also don't like that Jackery really picks and chooses which units are expandable, which this unit is not. For its size, it would be pretty awesome if you could just throw an expansion battery on it, tie it in, extend that trip, but not having to upgrade the unit itself. So being expandable would be a huge plus for us. And the last thing is that there's just nothing really wow worthy. Given it's a new product line, the HomePower that's been launched, you'd think that Jackery would go all out and make some big feature that can really get you excited about the unit. Yeah, it performs well, but there's nothing that really grabbed our attention out of the ordinary on this guy. Even the Jackery 5000, which we just reviewed, it was a wow. It performed really good. You could tell they went out of their way to make an outstanding unit. It performed great, held true to the Jackery name, but we were just hoping for a little bit more of a difference and a wow factor. Overall, it is a great unit, especially at this price point. We were super happy with how it performed. I would be more than satisfied taking this on a camping trip with me, using it as a backup power station for a small off-grid tiny home or a cabin. Leave a comment and let us know what you think about the Jackery HomePower 3000. But for now, that's all we have for you. While you're down there, check out any discount codes that we can get a hold of for you. Details on this month's giveaway. Give us a subscribe if you haven't already. But for now, peace out and stay charged.